guys, as you guys can tell from the title, this is a get ready with me and story time about a time that my sister and I almost got kidnapped in Mexico. I'm gonna do my makeup and then, you know, tell you guys about what happened. Anyways, for those of you who don't know me, my name is Lorena Medina and I love makeup. I just wanted to go ahead and do YouTube for fun, so yeah. I already went ahead and did my foundation and everything just so that those videos wouldn't be so long, because on my last video, all the editing, it took forever, and then it was really confusing because the videos weren't so organized, I guess you could say, when I was putting it in, and it was just really confusing. So I already went ahead and did the basics. I don't really usually do my foundations and my whole face before doing a eyeshadow look, only because of the fallout, but we're just gonna have to say well. I already went ahead and primed my eyes with the L'Oreal Infallible concealer in the shade 355 Vanilla. I'm gonna tell you guys what products I'm gonna be going in with so that you guys can know, and then so that while I'm telling the story time, you know. Well, I don't know. We'll see how it goes. But we're going to go in with Dominique Cosmetics, and this is called Celestial Thunder Palette. We're going to go in with Zero Gravity, which is this one, and we're going to use this kind of brush, okay? Because we're going to sketch it out for that. Because this is a really dark color, and we don't want to kind of fuck it up. So with the fluffy brush, I'm going to go ahead and blend it out. Now the brushes that I use, they're really cheap. Mines are from like everywhere. If you guys noticed that, I have some morphe brushes. I only have like two, so I don't really use a lot of brand brushes. I just use brushes that I think would work. And we're gonna go and start to sketch it. We're gonna, when you start to sketch it, kind of remember go with the, go up here. It's tough, huh? On the brow bone. Gonna softly just make it like that. And then we're gonna go with the brush like this and kind of like, you know, fluff it out. It was 10th grade year. It was 9th grade summer. My mom, she's just somehow found out that we had relatives that were here in town. And what they do is they get anything that you like. So for example, I got a lot of palettes and I wanted to go ahead and send it to Mexico for some family members. That's what they do. Everybody trusted them to get whatever they wanted to give their relatives over back in Mexico. My mom found out that she was in Georgia, and my sister, my mom and I, we've been talking about going to Mexico, but honestly, I did not want to go. My mom didn't really give a fuck about what I thought. She didn't really give a fuck about my feelings. And she says, you're going to Mexico. She's like, a mí no me importa. You're going to go to Mexico and you're going to meet your pa. And so I was like, I, not that I didn't want to meet my grandpa. I obviously do, but I was just scared because it was a whole other country. It was just going to be my sister and I. And I've heard some things. I was like scared. I was like, what if, you know, like, and I watched a lot of like Mexican, not Mexican movies, but like novellas, and I know how, I don't know, but I kind of figured about, not figured, but I kind of had something pictured in my head already that wasn't like pretty. So I was just like, you know, I'm scared. What if, you know, what if I get like trafficked or I don't know, because yeah, so I was just, and I don't know, and I've just never met these people. Like, my grandparents were literally, I mean, I've talked to them on the phone and stuff, obviously. My grandma, she lives in a ranch, and that's a place where you don't really have much signal. At that time, they were slowly but surely setting up, like, internet towers, but they haven't set one up nearby on her ranch. We couldn't FaceTime her, and if we ever did, it'd be, like, every now and then. She's a lawyer in Mexico, and she's really busy, so even when we were there, she was really busy, too. But my mom, anyways, found out that someone was going to go to Mexico, and like, it was my dad's cousin, so she was like, you know what, you guys are gonna go to Mexico, get your stuff ready. Like, it was, that was last minute. It was last minute, and I was crying and I was saying, no, I don't want to go. But we ended up needing to go because my mom, she had called them, and then they had the money, and my mom, she just, but I mean, I understand her side, but how you gonna do that to me? I love you, ma, I forgive you, but damn, that was fucked up. You knew I was scared. But anyways, they were cool people, though. They were really cool people. And they knew a lot of like my stepsisters, my family, stuff like that, but I just never met these people, so I was just like, so it was like, you know, when family but strangers. Oh, I didn't tell you this part. It was in Georgia. We had to go to Georgia, so we had to literally pack up our bags. And then my mom, my dad, and everyone just like hopped in the car, and they were like, okay, we're going to Georgia, and that's where we're going to drop you off. When we drop you off, that's where your cousins, you know, are going to be, and your theos and uncles, and they're going to tell you what's going to, you know, what's going to happen pretty much. And then they talked to my parents about the whole trip too, and how, you know, they assured us, how they assured them that we were going to be safe. And they were like, you know what, don't worry, they're in good hands, we're going to take good care of them, and stuff like that. And I was like so scared. I was nervous as fuck. I felt like this was human trafficking. I was really, and I'm also a crybaby. Oh, I was pissed. I was so pissed. Oh well, you gonna stay there pissed. It's low-key funny now that I think about it. Because I was so dramatic. I was just scared because, you know, I was always with my parents and I don't go anywhere without them. And dude, you're gonna send me off to these strangers who I don't even fucking know. And I know, you know, it's my dad's cousins and, you know, he's over there talking to them and getting along. But I was just like, I don't know you. Now we're gonna go in with the Violet Voss Essentials and we're gonna go in with Black. Why do I always do this? This is what we're gonna go away. Because I went in the back and I went to go talk to my prima. It's like, I think she knew them. I'm not sure if she knew them, but, you know, our family there, they were like, you know, supportive. They're like, it's gonna be okay. Like, you don't gotta worry about it. And when they were talking to us, yes, the words were comforting, but it was so scary. Like, you could not say anything in my mind that'll calm me down, except for food. So my parents dropped us off and I was literally crying my eyes out. I remember, and I was telling Carrie, no, I didn't want to go, please don't leave. And I was really attached to my little sister. She I just remember, I think she was sleeping or something, and they just ended up leaving us. I think I fucked that up. Low key, huh? And it was kind of cool, like, when, you know, being over at your favorite cousin's house, you know, how things just get distracted because you're with someone who you know. So I was like, you know what, it's not even that bad or whatever. And my Theo, we went to Walmart and he was like, come on, Mija, don't cry no more. And it was my cousin, my sister, and me. He was just like, you know, get anything that you want, you know. Just kind of just for us to not, well, especially me, because I was a crybaby, not to cry. I'm gonna go in with the L'Oreal concealer to do the cut crease. I love cut creases, I guess you could say. I'm gonna go in with this pink. Okay, same. You can get these from Instagram. On the first video that I posted, I found a page where I can get it, but I'll go ahead and put it in the description where you guys can find me on pigmented eyeshadows. I'm gonna go in with this flat brush right here, the same flat brush that I always use. So we went to Walmart with my tío. You know, he was just like, quiero lo que quiera, mija. So Karina, Juliana, and I, we all went crazy. And we didn't stay up all night, but we did try to pull an all-nighter. And it kind of, you know, eventually we ended up falling asleep and whatnot. Then we wake up in the morning and they're telling us to be ready by a certain time. So before we even leave, Karina, my sister, and I, we go to a Mexican store. Why should take it?
Karina, why did you put your thing? Oh, the yellow. Why did you put your thing? This one already came. Oh. I wasn't thinking. Put that drink.
Say hi to my mom.
That was actually our first time we tried a mango nada. I remember just, you know, getting our snacks and we were just talking and I was just, you know, telling. We were just like chilling or whatever. My uncle and my aunt came and picked us up. We already crossed the border or whatever. When we went to Mexico, we spent the majority of time with our grandma, But my grandma, like I mentioned, she's a lawyer, so she didn't, when she was busy, we would, like, you know, wait in the car, or we would just stay at the ranch. One day, my grandma, it was weird, because it was summer, now that I think about it, and it was cold, so it didn't make no sense. And there were people on the side of the street, they were selling elote. You know, my sister and I, we decided that we wanted to go. And my grandma, I don't know why she told us, because we were young and, you know, stupid. My grandma was like, okay, so I have a meeting to go to. While I'm at this meeting, across the street, there's a mall. But instead of crossing the road, you guys can take this bridge. And so that's what my sister and I, we did. We were just waiting around, and then after that, I don't know whose idea it honestly was. I don't want to take the fault, so I'm going to say my sister. But then again, my sister's, like, more quiet. I'm the one that, you know, let's do it. Let's just, you know, like, fuck it, why not? Before we even got off the car, I mean, went over to the mall, we got off the car, we got some elotes, we got some coffee, we got some bread, and we were munching in the car. And then we just got bored, and we're just like, you know what, let's go. I'm pretty sure it was me that said it. So I was like, you know what, let's go. Why not, while she's in there, and then we can be out. We're not gonna take long, we're just gonna go there for like 30 minutes to an hour, and we'll be right back. We just wanted to go look around, and then if we, you know, just do a little shopping. So then after that, I remember Liliana and I, we were walking into the mall, and well, before we even got there, there was this one big ass bridge instead of crossing the road. This bridge was so tall, like it was really tall, and I was just scared. I was scared to cross it because I'm scared of heights. Liliana was holding my hand, and I was like, okay, like, you know, she was walking me down the aisle, and we eventually got out, but it did take us a good minute because I was looking down and it was so high. We ended up getting off and going into the mall, and my grandma, she told us specifically, do not speak English. Do not. This fucking bitch was like, okay, remember what my aunt, what our grandma said, don't speak English. Dude, you just fucking said it. And then after that, I was like, okay. I was just like, you know what? Just lower your voice. We're not going to speak it. And of course, my sister and I, we started arguing because we were telling each other not to speak English. And that's exactly what we were doing as we were entering the mall. But we weren't even that loud, though. We kind of like whispering and arguing. We ended up coming to an agreement in the mall. And we were looking around, not even for long. We went to the bathroom because I don't even know who had to go, but we ended up going to the bathroom. We noticed that there was a security guard outside the bathroom. And they were like, did you guys come with the man? And we were like, no. They were like, okay, because you guys have two men following you right now. And we were like, we were fucking freaked out because we didn't have a man figure with us to defend us. We were jits. We didn't have no kind of like weapon to even defend ourselves or anything like that. The security guard asked us if we wanted to be escorted to, you know, around the mall. And then after that, we were just like, yeah. Like, we looked at each other and we were like, fuck yeah. So that's what they were doing. So whenever we were going to, like, you know, the section malls, we would go into one. They immediately started with the walkie-talkie. They were like, you know, I don't even remember what they said, but they started talking, and my sister, it wasn't even comfortable at that point, like, to even look around and shop. So I don't even know how we ended up just leaving from there. But honestly, Mexico was fun as fuck. We have a cousin there who smoked weed, and he was just cool as fuck. We had already smoked weed, my mom didn't know at the time. We ended up going to Reynosa, which is by the border. And it's nice, it was nice. But the thing is that there's a lot of, there isn't a lot, but there is, we did see some crazy shit there. Like, my sister, I was just on the FaceTime with her, and we were just talking about it, what kind of story time I should do. And she was like, why don't you do the time that you were, when we were in Mexico, almost got kidnapped. I was like, you're right. She mentioned how, she was like, do you remember? It was a white Hummer truck that was running away from the military. And I was just like, ooh. As they were, it looked like they were fleeing away with some from something, and they were. They had, there was a house, and they, I guess they had contacted them, and they had opened the car garage, and they just disappeared from the street, getting away from the military people that were there chasing them. They had like the military big ass trucks, and it was wild. So before we even noticed that, we were on our way to the park to go smoke. Well, it's such a nice place though. It doesn't even look like how you would think it is when people do shit like that. I fell in love with like the food, the culture, the people. I really love Mexico. I'm so proud of being Mexican, dude. Well, my mom. Okay, so my mom, she's Mexican-Italian. She's Mexican-Italian and Spaniard. My grandma, she's Spaniard, and my grandpa, he's Italian. And my mom was born in Mexico. So we're gonna go on the block in a corner and just dab it in there. Build it up. The eyeliner that I'm going in, it's the Wet n Wild eyeliner. This glitter right here, I got it from Sally's. This is the glitter primer also that I'm using. Oh. Put it on the line right there.
My mama say bitches be watching you. They gon' put their hand all in your pocket, but they credit card that's in your wallet. Drinking liquor when we celebrating. Calculating on my phones, trying to get a nigga take the kind of mile, cause she want that tax every month.
So now that we're up close and personal, this is the mess that I created. My heart. But it's okay, because I'm just going to sweep it up and put it inside here. So it ain't that bad. And we're just going to go ahead and blend it on the outer.
I like it. I really fuck with it.
So this is the... Oh, nope. I need some new clothes. So this is the completed look right here. I wanted to kind of bring it up closer to you guys so that y'all could see it. It came out. I hope you guys enjoyed this look and this video. Don't forget to like it and comment. I want to know where you guys would wear this kind of eyeshadow to. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video.